Good morning, children. Hello, hi everyone. How are you, everyone? Mainly, of course, when I ask you how are you, you ask me about how are you, sir. Yes, of course, I am very, very super. I am very, very excited. Why? Because today onwards, I am going to start the classes. So today onwards, I am going to start your classes. The first of all, we are going to learn about the number system. This number system is very, very useful. This number system is coming from you from 6th class, 7th class, 8th class, right or wrong? So why this number system will use? This number system is nothing but, here we are going to discuss about types of numbers. What are that? Types of numbers. What are the types of numbers we have? And how we will use this one? So mainly this number system will work like in our social, we have solar system. Like that same one, this also will work. The first one, whatever we have, the first type of number system, the first type of number system is natural numbers. What is that? Natural numbers. These natural numbers are denoted with the capital letter N. These natural numbers are denoted with the capital letter N. These natural numbers will start from 1, 2, 3 and so on up to infinity. So the first type is natural numbers. These are denoted with the capital letter N, and these are starts with the from 1 to infinity, and this will be represented like this, capital letter N. The representation in this one, this bracket system, this is called the set of natural numbers. So this is the first type. So when we add zero to the natural numbers, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on up to infinity, these numbers we call as a whole numbers. What we call? Whole numbers. Second type is whole numbers. These whole numbers are denoted with the capital letter N. These whole numbers are starts from 0 and ends at the infinity. So that means this, the set of whole numbers means we can represent like this. We can represent in the lower brackets. So that means what is this condition here? All the natural numbers are called the whole numbers. All the natural numbers are called the whole numbers. Next. This is about the whole numbers. Next. Third one. Here if you see, 1 to infinity are natural numbers. 0 to infinity are whole numbers. So what do you think? Yes, numbers are over. But if you observe here, 0 to infinity or 1 to infinity, all these are positive numbers. What are called? Positive numbers. Positive 1, positive 2, positive 3. Right or wrong? Like this up to positive infinity. But we have negative numbers also. Right or wrong? We have negative numbers. So what are they? Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, like this up to minus infinity are there. Right or wrong? So the set of negative numbers, the set of minus infinity to 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on up to infinity. The set of numbers from minus infinity, minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 0, like this and so on up to, all these numbers we call as a integer numbers. These all integer numbers are denoted with the letter Z, O-R-R-I, Z, O-R-R-I, mainly most of all using the letter Z to represent them. So the set of integers are minus infinity to plus infinity. So now what is the this condition statement now? According to Paradise, what we consider this one? All whole numbers and all natural numbers are in the part of integers. Are in the part of integers. So these are the integers. This is the third type of integers. So up to here we learn in 6th class and in 7th class also we are going to learn. But one more. Already we know that how can we represent the fractions? Fractions will represent the numerator and denominator. This is fraction. Better now. This is fraction, numerator and denominator. So the form P by Q, but Q not equals to 0. Q not equals to 0. Like this of numbers we call as a rational numbers. Rational numbers. The biggest collection of numbers. The biggest collection of numbers. Rational numbers are denoted with the capital letter Q. Capital letter Q. It is in the form of P by Q, but denominator never becomes the 0. If the denominator is 0, it is not a rational number. It is not undefined. It is not undefined. So the rational numbers are represented with the letter Q. So that means all these numbers, whatever natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, are all the part of this rational numbers. Are all the part of this rational numbers. Next, after this we have fifth one, real numbers. What is this? Real numbers. These real numbers are represented with the capital R, and these real numbers are the biggest. Whatever we have the numbers in, whatever, however you are writing the numbers, all are the belongs to this real numbers. That means all natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers, everything, all numbers we call them as a real numbers. These real numbers are represented with the capital letter R. Okay, so this is all about the number system. This is all about the number system. So how we will see this one? Simply we will see. So simple way of representing, I am showing you the small diagram to you all. So how can we understand simply? With a small diagram we will understand. For suppose natural numbers represented with capital M, and here are all numbers from 1 to infinity. Right or wrong? Capital M, natural numbers. Next, what is the type of next natural numbers? Next numbers? Whole numbers. What is that? Whole numbers. Whole numbers are from 0, 1, 2, infinity. Whole number. That means, first, all natural numbers are the part of whole numbers. Next, integers. Minus infinity to minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, or 3 infinity. All these are all integers. This is also the biggest collection of numbers. Next one is rational numbers. Rational numbers are in the form of P by Q, but Q not equals to 0. So that means all these rational numbers, all are belongs to the rational numbers. Next one is real numbers. Real numbers are all numbers. All type of numbers. These real numbers will come you in the 9th class for you. These real numbers will come you in the 9th class for you. So in 6th class, up to 6th class you will learn up to natural numbers. In 6th class you are going to learn about whole numbers. In 7th class you are going to learn about integers. In 8th class you are going to about full detail about the rational numbers. In rational numbers, one more type also is there, that is the irrational numbers. If you see some numbers, you see like this 0.333333333, some numbers √3, √4, √5, like this of numbers are there. How can we represent the like this of numbers? Means these numbers are part of rational numbers, but this rational of these numbers we call as a irrational numbers. Irrational numbers. So this irrational numbers will discuss in deep in the 8th class. In the 8th class. So this is overall about the number system. This is overall about the number system. So I think everyone understand deeply about this number system. So once again I'll briefly explain this very shortly. Natural numbers are denoted with the capital N, whole numbers are denoted with the W, integers are represented with the Z, or rational numbers are represented with the Q, and real numbers are represented with the R. So remember all of these symbols, how we are denoting the number system. Okay? Students, now we learn about the number system. In the number system, what is our third type of number, third type of number system? That is the integer numbers. So this is our first chapter in our 7th class. This is our first chapter, integers. So integers are represented with the capital letter I over Z. Capital letter I over Z. And the set of integers, the set of integers are all negative numbers, 0, and all positive numbers. All negative numbers, 0, and positive numbers. All numbers we call as a integer numbers. Better. So these integer numbers. So of course in previous class we'll see how to represent the numbers in a number line. How to represent the numbers in a number line. Now we are going to discuss how to represent these integers on number line. So how do I mean? First of all, we have to draw one number line. And now, see, these integers are start from minus infinity. Minus infinity means from where you start, we don't know. That's why in the integers, first of all, we have to start from 0. In the middle, starts from 0. From 0, the right side, all these are positive numbers. From 0 to left side, all these are negative numbers. All these are negative numbers. From 0, from positive side starting is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. Up to wherever you want, you can write up to infinity. From here, you can see minus 1 starting, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, and so on. So if you observe here, from 0 to when we are going to right side, positive numbers, the numbers are increasing their value also. 1 is bigger than, 1 is smaller than 2, 2 is smaller than 3. Like this, it is increasing order. Here, in negative numbers, the digits values will decrease. That means minus 1 is the biggest negative number. And next it is the smaller. And which is the smallest negative number? Means minus infinity is the smallest negative number. When you see minus 6 or minus 10, it is think that this is the bigger than minus 1. No, it's not bigger than the minus 1. This is smaller values than the minus 1. Okay. So don't confuse here everyone. Okay. In positive numbers it will increase, but in negative numbers it will decrease the values. So that means which is the smallest positive number means 1. Smallest positive number is 1. Biggest positive number means infinity. And smallest negative number means minus infinity, and biggest negative number means minus 1. So now this is the representation of number line. This is the representation of numbers in a number line. Right or wrong? Now, for suppose if they give us add, we have to add. For suppose they give us minus 7 plus 8. We have to add this one. That means where 7 is starting? Here. Right or wrong? What, when we add 8 to this one, what will come? 8 minus 7 how much? 1. Right or wrong? What is that? 1. From here it will go. It's plus 7 or minus 1. That means 1. Whatever the biggest value, before biggest value, which symbol is there? That is the here answer also. That means plus 1. That means where will come? From here to plus 1. So this is the addition. This is the addition. That means minus 7 plus 8 is equals to 1. This is the way of representing additions. We are representing additions. For suppose if they do like this, we have to subtract. We have to subtract minus 7, minus half, minus 8. We have to subtract here. See, if you observe here, minus into minus, plus will come. Negative, product of two negative numbers is plus. That means minus 7 plus 8. So again, what will become? 1. Again, also 1 will come. Later on. For suppose, if you want to add 8 minus 7, what is the answer? 1. That means from where we have to go? 6, 7, 8. Starting is plus 8. That means from here to we have to subtract 1. This is 8 minus 7, 1. So like this we have to add and subtract. For suppose we have to multiply 3 into 2. That means how much? 6. Right or wrong? So from 3 to, this is 3 into 2 is equals to 6. Directly we can do it. Okay? This is the addition, subtraction, and divisions also we can do it. Divisions means, for suppose we can take division, 9 divided by 3, that means 3. What will come? 3 ones are 3 threes are. That means from 9 to become 3. So this is 9 divided by 3, that equals to 3. Like this we can do. So here you are getting some confusions here. Where we have to come, where we have to come. So that's why we can do the simple one problem, one time we have to do. Don't do all the problems in a one single number line. For each and every problem, you have to draw the new number line. For each and every number, numbers or any problem, you have to draw the new number line. So here, observe here, very very important in the numbers. What is means? When we the product of two positive numbers is always positive. The product of two negative numbers is also always positive. Next, the product of one positive number and one negative number is always negative. Next, the product of one negative number and one positive number is also a negative. See, when we are multiplying same numbers, that means same positive numbers, we will get the same thing. Here also, same negative numbers will product, we will also get the addition. But when we multiply opposites, we will get the negative numbers. So this is about the multiplication. Now we will see division. So division also same. When we divide two positive numbers, answer will become the positive only. When we divide two negative numbers, we will get the positive only. And when we divide one positive number and one negative number, we will get negative number. When we divide one negative number and one positive number, we will get the negative only. Same like this only also we will get. So these two are the very very important. Please don't confuse here. This is the showing of number line. This is the showing of number line. Next, we have
three rules to find the integers. When we add two positive integers, the result will be always positive. When we add two negative integers, the result will be always negative. And when we add the one positive and one negative number, the result will be positive is greater than positive. If negative is greater, negative. And here I am showing you some rules of integers, how to add, how to subtract, and how to multiply and divide. Please check it, observe and carefully.
Children, this is about the first topic, how to show the integers on a number line. We learned in this class, and also we learned about the number system. What are the types of number systems we learned? So now everyone, we have to watch this. I am going to send you worksheet, depends on these both topics. One topic is number system, one more topic is how to show the number line, how to show the integers on a number line, how to add, how to subtract, how to multiplication, how to do the division on number lines. I am going to send you practice worksheets, and also I am going to send you introduction of first chapter. So you have to write in a new notebook. And whatever I am sending you worksheet, whatever I am sending you exercises, please do it in a rough work and copy in the after introduction please copy. And if you have any doubts, everyone have my number. Of course, if anyone don't have my number, I am giving you my number. Please, you can call me or you can WhatsApp me your doubts by this number. You can WhatsApp me or you can call directly and you can ask me your doubts. So with this today, I am concluding today's topic. So thank you, dear children.